about going in a decree. If you find anybody praying in the church, you don't hear me. If you find anybody calling on the Lord, if you find anybody that don't care about, that care about the Lord, he wanted to stop them. He was out of the church, but needed to be in. There are people that out of the church, but they got something to say about the inside church. They talking about the preacher ain't right, and the member not right. But they're not in the church. They're out of the church. Sometimes they're passed by the church, but they still don't want to be a part of the church. But you got to realize that the church is made by God. God said, upon this rock, I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And since the church is built on Jesus Christ, then it's not a good thing to fight the church. And look at Saul on his way to Damascus. He wanted to go there and stop the church. He was on his way with a decree. He had a sign by the head men. If you find anybody call on the Lord, you can bring them bound back here to Jerusalem. I'm glad that as he was traveling, if you were traveling on the road toward the church, you don't know, but sooner or later you're going to run into the Lord. Yes, you will. You're going to have to meet him if you're going against him. You're going to meet him one of these days. Look at Saul going to fight the church. And when you're going to fight the church, you're going to fight Jesus. And Jesus saw him coming down the Damascus Road. Can't you see him traveling? But he wasn't by himself. And while he was traveling, a voice from heaven. Says, Saul, why persecute thy me? It's hard for you to kick against the brick. Yes, sir. I heard Saul saying, yes, who are thy Lord? He told him, I'm Jesus whom thy persecute. Yes, sir. Saul realized that he was in the presence of God. He realized he was with Jesus present now. He fell to the ground. He could see when he was falling. But when he hit the ground, when he realized he couldn't see anymore. Yes, sir. When he rose up, he heard the voice, but he couldn't see no man. But all those that were with him, they heard the voice, but they saw no man. I heard Jesus said to Saul, oh, Saul, you go down to Damascus. I got something I want you to do there. He went on his way. He was blind and could not see. You know what I mean? Yes, Lord. But when he got there, he realized he needed the Lord. When you blind, you don't realize you need the Lord. And he began to pray and fast because he wanted his sight back. Yes, sir. And not only that, he wanted what the other Christian had. He wanted that Holy Spirit. Oh, you don't hear me. And look at the good Lord send a servant by the name of Ananias came to Saul. I heard him say, Lord, Ananias, Lord, I've heard much about this man. Yeah. And I says, are you sure you want me to go meet him? He said, oh yes, you go meet him. He's a changed man now. He's here to learn how to suffer for me now. And you go there. And I saw his tears. Now, whenever I got there, he put his head on him. And Saul received the Holy Ghost. You don't hear me? When he received the Holy Ghost, he wanted to get busy for the Lord. The church, but now he's in the church. His mind is on Jesus now. It was on against Jesus, but now it's on Jesus. Now his mind is staying on Jesus. Nothing wrong with letting your mind stay on Jesus. Every once in a while, to sing a song. My mind is staying on Jesus. Yes, sir. Look at Saul. Name came from Saul to Paul. And when the name got changed, many of them didn't recognize the name Paul. They would recognize Saul because Saul was a persecutor of the church. But Saul was a servant of the church. Look at Paul. Now he's a servant. He's not a persecutor. He is a new creature now. Talking about Paul. Saul, that old name, he didn't need it no more. He got a new name. We all have got a new name now. I'm no longer that name I used to be. Some of them used to call me trouble coming. And others would say the devil is coming. Some may say, yes, he is a thief. Some may say he is a killer. But when you meet Jesus, they can't call you that no more. You've been changed. The old thing that you used to do, you don't do it no more. Oh Lord, look at Paul. Now he's getting ready to serve the Lord. And when you is ready to serve the Lord, the Lord got something for you to do. Yes, son, you gotta make up your mind. Which side you're on? Yes, I heard one of God's servants saying, we going down to Mount Carmel, and the people wasn't sure whose side they were on. You say, well, the God that answered by fire, let him be God. You come with all of the false prophets, and you can call on your mighty God as long as you want to. But let me tell you, just give me a chance. I call on my God. Look at them. They went down to Mount Carmel. Elijah went along with them. They called on the idol God because they didn't believe in the true God. The people standing there looking at the false prophets, and they were calling on the idol God. After a while, it got late in the evening. They had cut themselves with stones and everything, trying to make the idol God move, but he did not move. I heard the prophet sang. Elijah said, well, perhaps he's on a journey somewhere. Perhaps your God is sleeping somewhere.